Welcome back to the channel where we continue on with our Google Analytics 4 conversion for 2023. Remember, June is coming up fast and GA4 is already out and about. We've got videos on how to install GA4. Today, we're going to talk about the pages and screen report. So if you've newly converted to GA4 and want to see what this is about, it replaces the all pages report in Universal Analytics. We'll show you where to find it and how to use it. It is the pages and screen report in GA4. Remember, a lot of things that are in GA4 do replace what's in Universal Analytics. You just got to learn how to create those reports and replace them. And once you actually spend some time in there, it's a lot more easier. And the all pages report, this is an example. It did show your page views, your unique page views, your time on page, entrances, your bounce rate. So the all pages report was very prominent in Universal Analytics, and a lot of people grew accustomed to this, and now they can't find it when they make the transition to GA4. So we're going to show you where to find this all pages report and how to get it set up so that you can take a look at all of your different pages, or if you have an app, you can take a look at some of the different screens and some of the different metrics that are being used on that page. So that's the all pages report. Let's get to it in GA4. GA4, from your home screen, you're going to go to your engagement, and in the engagement is your pages and screen report. So that is where it's located in GA4. It's called the pages and screen report. And once you click on that, your pages and screen report comes up. And what this does is shows all of your pages, and it's very similar to the all pages report. You can see your views, your users, your average engagement time, and then the events that happened for that page. So this shows if you've got an app, all of your different apps. If you've got screens, you can take a look at your page title and then see. And then again, if you want to go down to a second dimension, it gives you the option to do that as well. But your pages and screen report is definitely something you want to look at and monitor. Try to do this once a month if you're not adding or changing a lot of pages out. If you're adding new products to your e-commerce site, or if you're promoting different landing pages through some of your other channels, then you may want to take this a little bit more often. But the metrics that you want to take a look at is your views, your users, your average views per user, your average engagement time. Those are the different metrics that are going to be available on your pages and screen report. So make sure to understand those metrics. Remember, metrics are the numbers, the actual raw totals, and then your dimensions are the categories or the buckets that you're trying to look at and monitor. So a bucket would be United States users. That would be a dimension. Dimension would be your country. And then you'd have your different countries, United States, Canada, Europe, and then you would go down to your metrics. So then you would look at your views and your users by each of those countries to take a look at the different dimensional settings. Now you do want to you can customize your pages and screen report. You can add extra dimensions. You can view by the page title. You can use your comparison and your filter functions. So if you've not used your comparison and filter functions, that allows you to compare to other metrics or filter out some of the traffic that you don't want to see. So it looks like this. Your comparison is right next at the top of your pages and screen report, and then your filters just below that, pages and screen. So make sure to use these two tools to add your comparisons and filter out the pages and screens that you do not want to see or some of the traffic. This is where you really start to become a ninja and start to really factor in some of the web traffic that is driving your conversions, driving your events, and getting people to actually convert on your website. So why would you want to use your pages and screen report? Well, you can look at your popular blog post. You can look at your content optimization. Maybe you should be writing more content on things that get more views. You can look at your mobile app and look at your performance and screens that get a lot of traffic. Maybe that's where you want to put your rules or some of the different unique messages for people that sign in to your app. And you can use your pages and screen report to help with your content optimization and to prioritize your content for SEO purposes to try to get some of your keyword rankings for your SEO content. So your pages and screen report, remember the 80-20 rule, 20% of your pages will have 80% of your page views. So you're gonna focus in for every 10 pages you have out there, you're gonna focus in on two or three pages, optimize it for SEO, optimize it for your call to action, make sure to have your newsletter signups and email signups on those pages. But the small number of pages will drive 80% of your conversions, and you need to know which those pages are doing that on your website so you can update your content, make sure your content is accurate, and make sure your SEO is optimized on those pages. That is a look at the pages and screen report as we continue to make the transition to Google Analytics 4.